This is Match Game 74, production number 0202, take one.
Get ready to match the star. Bobby Vann. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly. Elaine Joyce. Richard Dawson. And Betty White. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now, here's the host of Match Game 74, Gene Rayburn.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you, Johnny Olson. Thank you for joining us here today. Are you all ready, gang?
Yeah,
ready. Splendid. I just want to say one thing before we carry on. This is the week that Bobby Vann is appearing at the Playboy Club in Lake Geneva, Wisconsin.
Right. Thank you very much. Okay. You got my dancing shoes on.
That's right.
Yes, wait, look at all those Fred Astaire's. They're great.
He wears them all of his life.
Let's hear it, folks.
You had something to say? You had your hand raised, sir?
Is this the week that Bobby's going to play? Yesterday we had a thing for Annie on the board.
Oh, Annie Greensprings, yeah.
What was it last?
Well, I've got to say,
I never heard of that.
We didn't have time to explain it. It's a local product, a wine, that apparently local people were familiar with, so we do owe the rest of the country an explanation of
Annie
why that answer.
Annie Greensprings is a wine, is it?
Yeah, all the local winos know about it. It's a local thing, so.
Annie Sterno, I've heard of.
Let's say hello to the current champ here, Debbie Marialdo. How are you? As we ran out of time yesterday, Debbie had just won a game, and she had completed part of the super match in which she won $500. That means she's up to now $700, right? And she'll be having a go at $5,000. Are you ready for that?
Oh, I'm ready.
Okay, we'll do that right after we do this message for you. All right, here we go. Here's a lady. Let's stand right here so they can all see your pretty face, and we'll have a go at it. Now, you've won the $500. That means you're going to be playing for 10 times that amount, or $5,000. To collect, remember, you've got to match one celebrity on a head-to-head basis. It has to be an exact match, and it's time to choose one now.
I'm Bobby.
Bobby Vann.
Right, okay.
You have been chosen. You get ready to write.
I appreciate your confidence.
Debbie, you face me. And I'll get the...
I like it better when she faces me, if you don't mind.
Here it is. Fill in, write your answer to this, if you please. Marriage blank. Marriage blank.
Marriage blank. Okay.
Marriage blank.
Okay.
All right, Bobby is finished. Now we need a response from you, Debbie. How do you fill in that blank? Marriage...
Contract.
Contract. If the phone rings, I'll answer it. But I don't know about that. Is that a good one?
That's a good one.
That's a good one. She says that's a good one and don't
all
her.
They all go around and boo, right? But I believe that license and contract are the same thing.
Marriage license and marriage contract? No.
No, it isn't.
The rule says, has to be an exact match. We say that at the beginning of every time.
License and contract.
But you're both on the same wavelength there, and it may happen next time if you win another game. Who knows? But right now, Debbie, you're going to play another game, meet another challenger. Here comes Jolene Lehman. All right, Jolene, we welcome you and ask you to tell us a little bit about yourself.
Well, I live in Canoga Park with my wonderful husband and my two children. Kim is 8 and Michael is 6.
Kim and Michael.
Uh-huh, and we enjoy to water ski and snow ski and bowl.
Really? Where do you snow ski?
Oh, we usually go to Utah and visit my relatives and
ski
there.
Yeah, they've got great snow up
there.
They
really do. It spoils you for down here.
Okay, good luck to you, Jolene. I'll push the button, reveal two questions, ask you to make a selection.
B.
She wants B. New game. Here we go. Okay. One flea said to the other flea, "My wife Gladys is a real social climber. She wants us to move from a dog to a blank." Two fleas are talking to each other. One says to the other, "My wife Gladys is a real social climber. She wants us to move from a dog to a blank." You like your answer, Brett.
No, but I sure like Charles's.
Go ahead, Charles. Write it down. We trust you. Okay, now here we go. Jolene, one flea said to the other, my wife Gladys is a real social climber. She wants us to move from a dog to a...
cat.
A cat. Is that a step up the social ladder? I guess so. I don't know. We'll find out right now. Bobby, you think that's a step up the social ladder?
I think that, I would say it's a Siamese cat, but it is a cat.
It is a cat. So there's one for you, Jolene. Correct?
Well, I figured you'd move from four legs to two, so I put a person.
A person. That's a good response.
Thank you, darling.
Yeah, she's they like that stretch. Answer. Charles?
People don't have fleas.
Horse!
A horse. Yeah, horse. Yeah, one flea said to you that my wife is a social climber and wants to move from a dog to a...
a person.
A person, yeah, right. What do you say there?
It's been scratching all day.
I never thought of a person. I said human.
A human. Okay. All right, cat's the answer that Jolene's looking for. What do you offer?
I was horsing around with Charles.
Oh, I see. Okay. So it's 1-0 at this moment. We'll come to your question in a few seconds. But right now we've got a message of interest to one and all, and this is it. Here we go. Second half of round one. Jolene scored one match in her half of the round, and now we'll see how Debbie does with this. Oh, this is a Godfather question.
Oh.
You want to bet it comes out Charlie Chan?
Oh, either tuck it right in, because you look like the godmother at the moment. Right. No, wrong.
Godfather said, Vito, I'm leaving the business in your hands. I'm going to Hollywood to blank Gene Rayburn. You didn't hear it?
I didn't.
You didn't hear it because I got a mouth full of sponges while you didn't hear it. The Godfather said, Vito, I'm leaving the business in your hands. I'm going to Hollywood to blank Gene Rayburn. Think about it. Are you ready over there? What the heck are you waiting for? Because
I hate to say it.
I was just gonna reach for my Gat, and my pocket is sewn up. I could, I'd be a failure in the gangster business, wouldn't I? Well, stick them up anyway, then. Are you ready now?
Ready.
Okay, I wish we'd get this over with. My mouth hurts. Debbie, I'm leaving the business in your hands. I'm going to Hollywood to blank Gene Rayburn.
To kill.
To kill?
Sorry.
Just for that, I'm going to pull a wire out of your telephone. To kill. It's an ugly thought, this sweet fella. Trying to make a living. What do you say?
First of all.
What?
I think I'm what? A relative.
Oh, yeah. You got some too, huh?
What flavor was he you? Went to Hollywood not to kill him, to kiss him.
To kiss
He's
him.
A pussy cat.
Right.
That's
right. That's the
kill
but
him.
That's the kiss of death.
Give him a kiss.
I'll kill him after I kill
right.
him.
Right. Brett, okay. What did you say?
I said shoot, and after that imitation, I'm gonna help him.
Kill. There's one match. Okay. Charles.
I said rub out.
Rub out or kill, there's another match. How about you?
Your feelings, but I mean, the way you said it and everything, I figured he was coming here to replace you.
To replace.
Sorry, but he couldn't. He couldn't.
Thank you. Thank you. You've almost saved yourself there. How about you, sir?
Yeah, I said, and I meant to kill, I just used the vernacular of the Godfather, you know, a contract and a hit.
And a hit. And okay, there's another man. Ready?
There's another what there?
Another match.
That's what he was coming out to do to Gene Rayburn.
To match Gene Rayburn.
Well, it's the match game.
Oh, yes, right, okay.
Now don't
so
get
So at the end of round one, 3-1 in favor of our current champ, Debbie, and we'll go to round two and see what we have for you, Jolene. Make a selection here.
I'll take B again.
B again for Jolene. Now, last time out, you matched Bobby, so Bobby, you do not participate. Little Bo Peep lost her sheep and didn't know where to find them. Hey, Bo Peep, said a friend, the Jolly Green Giant blanked them. Hear all that? Little Bo Peep lost her sheep, didn't know where to find them. Hey, Bo Peep, said a friend, the Jolly Green Giant blanked them. The Jolly Green Giant. Okay. Lower tier is ready, Charles. We're waiting for you.
We got any more paper? We need some more paper.
Okay.
Page 12.
Now, Jolene. Little Bo Peep lost her sheep and didn't know where to find them. Hey, Bo Peep, said a friend, the Jolly Green Giant blanked them.
Canned them or packaged them?
Canned them.
Thank you.
The Jolly Green Giant canned them sheep, according to her.
Brett, I would have said that, but I don't have
a chance. That's right. Brett, what do you say?
I don't want Betty White bursting into tears.
Yeah.
Right? He done ate them.
He ate them. No match there. All right, Charles.
I don't like violins, so I chose took them in from the rain.
Took them in from the rain.
Jesus.
It's a sweet thought there. Okay.
Instead of murder or kill.
Yes, right.
I was gonna write can, but I wrote eight.
Eight.
Sorry, I'm so
now,
mad.
Jolene, you must match Richard and Betty to stay in the game and achieve a tie. Richard.
Jolene, I only wish I had the word seven written here, but I have eight.
Eight. All right. What do you have there? Another eight.
That's what I did.
There's another $100. Congratulations to you. Jolene, it's been a pleasure meeting you.
Thank you.
I hope you enjoyed it.
I did, and I almost said eight. I just...
Jolene Lehman, a gift for you backstage. Thank you. Got to do a little business here, and then we'll carry on from this exact point. You ready?
I'm ready.
Okay, join us immediately.
Today's consolation prizes are American Tourister Go Anywhere Lightweight Luggage, Continental Styling and Carrying Ease, American Tourister, the casual luggage that isn't made casually, and Schick's Love Light Mirror, the right light for day, office, evening, home, plus Quick Curls Curling Iron, quick, easy curls that last from Schick. And Bissell's Sweepmaster Deluxe Feather Light Vacuum, straight through suction, float and lock brush, lifts dirt, pet hair, and lint in an Airstream from Bissell. Match game 74 will fill in the doggone it blanks when it continues in a minute.
Okay, here we are with Debbie Marialdo for the third time to see if she can win over $5,000. Are you ready, Debbie?
Yes.
Okay. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Kick the blank. Now, the answer they gave most often, remember, is worth $500 if you match it. If you match the next one, it's $250 and $100 for the bottom one. Which celebrities would you like a little help from?
Richard
Dawson,
something,
kick the...
Yeah, something that monks do to nuns. Kick the habit.
Kick the habit. Okay. Bobby Van.
Kick the ball.
Kick the ball. All
right.
Okay.
And Charles.
And Charles Nelson Reilly. Kick the...
That's very bad to talk about that, Richard. Nuns and... It's terrible. So I chose kick the bucket.
You're applauding death, are you? Is that what you're doing there? Okay, so you've got kick the habit, kick the bucket, and kick the ball. You may choose one of those as the answer or give us one of your own. What would you like to do?
I like kick the bucket.
You like kick the bucket?
Yeah.
Okay. We'll find out if it's up there, and if so, where. That's the one that Charles gave you. We're looking for kick the bucket. May we see the $100 response? Kick the habit. There's the one that Richard gave you. That's up there. All right, here we go. Looking for kick the bucket. Here is the $250 response. Kick the can. That's a game we all played as kids.
That's where they
I think.
Kick the habit.
Now, here's the last chance for kick the bucket. Here is the $500 response. Yeah! Okay. Debbie, you've got another chance to win the big money here. You've won the $500. You now play for 10 times that amount or $5,000. Remember, you have to match one celebrity head-to-head. Has to be exact. Please choose one now.
Richard.
Richard. Okay, you get ready to write. And Debbie's facing me, and here is the $5,000 question. Roller blank. Roller blank, R-O-L-L-E-R blank. No, you have to give us a response here. Now, he's filled in his answer, and we need a response from you. How do you fill in the blank?
Roller skate.
Roller skate. All right. Roller skate is her response. She thinks that will match you, Richard. May we see your answer for $5,000?
Yeah, I thought of a lot of roller skates. Roller derby.
Roller derby. Roller derby was the first thing that came to my mind, too. Roller skate was also good. Roller coaster is another good one. Did you have one?
No, but there's a call for you, Jane.
There is a call for me? Okay. Let's see. You what?
Take a message.
Oh, all right. She'll take a message. Can answer the phone herself. So where are you, Debbie? You know, you've been chipping away here, and you're up to $1,300, and that's pretty good. You're going to meet another challenger, and here comes Peggy Barfield.
Oh, yes.
Peggy, it's nice to have you with us. How are you today?
Fine, how are you?
Good, I'm very well, thank you for asking. Would you please tell us a little bit about yourself?
I'm married to a wonderful man that's sitting in the audience, and I have two daughters, Wanda and Leslie, and we live in North Hollywood, and they want me to bring home a piano.
Bring home a what?
A piano.
A piano?
Yeah.
Do we give away pianos here?
Sure.
Yeah, we will.
All right, we will. Okay, Peggy, anything your kids say is okay with us. Shall we begin? I'll push a button and ask you to make a selection, Peggy.
B.
New game, folks. This is it. Harry said that was some crazy wedding last night. Just as the bride said, I do, the best man blanked in the aisle. Did you hear all that? Harry said that was some crazy wedding last night. Just as the bride said, I do, the best man blanked in the aisle. Think about that for a moment while our celebrities are finishing. Bobby's the first one through there.
Charles. I don't want to think about that.
Yes, you better. Okay. All right. All set over there, so we'll call on Peggy. Harry said that was some crazy wedding last night. Just as the bride said, I do, the best man blanked in the aisle.
Fainted
in the aisle. The audience thinks you got a winner there, Peggy. We'll find out right now if that's a winner or not.
Well, I tell you, if he had any class, he'd fainted in the aisle.
Fainted in the aisle. Or one.
I was remembering my own classy wedding, and I said, threw up.
Okay, Charles?
No, I was very... When Peggy said she was married to a wonderful man in the audience, did you see four men got up? No, it's true, but I wasn't worried. They're the guys that are going to help move the piano. I said fainted.
Fainted. It looks like that piano may become a reality. What did you say?
I love a piano.
I love a piano.
And I'm so happy. I'm fainted.
Yeah. So far, it's three. Richard?
I was not at Brett's wedding. But just thinking about it made me throw up.
And Betty.
Now, when you faint, what do you do?
Throw up?
No.
You lie prone.
Fall.
You fall. He fell.
Oh.
No.
A little See, half one?
Well, he fell down. He fell down for another reason.
Oh, really?
Yeah, but I ain't saying. All right, you did pretty well with that. That's three for you, and now let's see how you do, Debbie, with this first round question. Grace said, I don't know if it's true or not, but I hear Liberace's underwear is lined with blank. Grace said that. Grace said that.
Grace who?
Just Grace.
Just Grace.
Girl who lives down the block.
Princess Grace.
Lined with...
Liberace's underwear is lined with... Okay. Everybody's ready? So we call on Debbie. Grace said, I don't know if it's true or not, but I hear Liberace's underwear is lined with...
piano keys.
Piano keys? Piano keys? Why, that would be very bulky. Do you know how funny he would walk? Oh, no. Piano keys? What do you say there?
Well, I say if he hits an A-flat, he'll be the happiest guy in town, I'll tell you what. I said the sequence. You know.
Sequence?
Yeah.
Brett?
If you think he walks funny with piano keys, how about pianos?
Pianos? Charles?
I said mink and not blonde either. Candle wax.
Okay. Elaine?
I said rhinestones.
Rhinestones. Yeah, that's what he wears on the outside, too. What do you say?
I feel terrible about answering this because Gary, my youngest son's godfather, is Liberace.
Uh-huh. Oh.
And I've never looked at his underwear, so I said sequins.
And you, Betty? Piano keys.
I wanted to say feathers because he smiles so much. I said mink along with Charles.
Okay. So it's 3-0 at the end of round one. Round two will come up next, but first, this has to happen.
Tune in, turn on, and blank out with That 70s Hour. Stay tuned.
Time is up, ladies. We'll pick it up at this exact point next round with the beginning of our second and final round next time. And we thank you. You're all splendid. And I hope you'll all be here full of vim and vigor and energy and all
Richard's
that stuff.
Richard's going to be on
time.
The Patsy Awards thank you. Tonight with us.
Richard's going to be
on the Patsy Awards
tonight. That's tonight. Let's all watch Betty White and Alan Ludden.
That's for sure.
And Richard
Gene
Dawson.
Rayburn. And Richard Dawson, too. Gene Rayburn for Mass Game 74. Join us next time.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 74. A Mark Goodson.
I could, I'd be a failure in the gangster business, wouldn't I? Well, stick him up anywhere, then. Are you ready now?
Ready.
Okay, I wish we'd get this over with. My mouth hurts. Debbie? I'm leaving the business in your hands. I'm going to Hollywood to blank Gene Rayburn.
To kill.
To kill?
Sorry.
Just for that, I'm going to pull the wire out of your telephone. You said to kill. It's an ugly thought, this sweet fella. Trying to make a living. What do you say?
First of all...
What?
I think I'm what? A relative.
Oh, yeah. He's got some, too, huh?
I said he you? Went to Hollywood not to kill him, to kiss him.
To kiss
He's
him.
Pussycat.
Right.
That's
right. That's the, but that's the kiss of death.
Give him a kiss.
I'll kill him after I kiss him.
Right. Brett, okay. What did you say?
I said shoot, and after that imitation, I'm going to help him.
Kill. There's one match. Okay. Charles?
I said rub out.
Rub out or kill. There's another match. How about you?
Well, I don't want to hurt your feelings, but, I mean, the way you said it and everything, I figured he was coming here to replace you.
To replace.
I'm sorry, but he couldn't. He couldn't.
Thank you. Thank you. You've almost saved yourself there. How about you, sir?
Yeah, I said, and I meant to kill. I just used the vernacular of the Godfather, you know, a contract and a hit.
And a hit. Okay, there's another match. Betty?
There's another what there?
Another match.
That's what he was coming out to do to Gene Rayburn.
To match. All right, Jolene, we welcome you and ask you to tell us a little bit about yourself.
Well, I live in Canoga Park with my wonderful husband and my two children. Kim is 8 and Michael is 6.
Kim and Michael.
Uh-huh, and we enjoy to water ski and snow ski and bowl.
Really? Where do you snow ski?
Oh, we usually go to Utah and visit my relatives and
yeah,
ski
they've
there.
Got great snow up
they
there.
They really do. It spoils you for down here.
Okay, good luck to you, Jolene. I'll push the button, reveal two questions, ask you to make a selection.
B.
She wants B. New game. Here we go. Okay. One flea said to the other flea, my wife Gladys is a real social climber. She wants us to move from a dog to a blank. Two fleas are talking to each other. One says to the other, my wife Gladys is a real social climber. She wants us to move from a dog to a blank. You like your answer, Brett?
No, but I sure like Charles's.
Go ahead, Charles. Write it down. We trust you. Okay, now here we go. Jolene. One flea said to the other, my wife Gladys is a real social climber. She wants us to move from a dog to a...
cat.
A cat. Is that a step up the social ladder? I guess so. I don't know. We'll find out right now. Bobby, you think that's a step up the social ladder?
I think that, I would say it's a Siamese cat, but it is a cat.
It is a cat. So there's one for you, Jolene. Brett?
Well, I figured you'd move from four legs to two, so I put a person.
A person. That's a good response.
Thank you, darling.
Yeah. They like that answer. Charles?
People don't have fleas.
Horse!
A horse. Yeah, one flea said to the other, my wife is a social climber, wants to move from a dog to a...
a person.
A person, yeah, right. What do you say there?
It's been scratching all day.
I never saw a person. I said human.
A human. Okay. All right, cat's the answer that Jolene's looking for. What do you offer?
I was horsing around with Charles.
Oh, I see. Okay. So it's 1-0 at this moment. We'll come to your question in a few seconds, but right now we've got a message of interest to one and all, and this is it. Here we go. Second half of round one. Jolene scored one match in her half of the round, and now we'll see how Debbie does with this. Oh, this is a Godfather question.
Oh.
You want to bet it comes out Charlie Chan?
Oh, either tuck it right in, because you look like the godmother at the moment. Right. No, wrong.
The godfather said, Vito, I'm leaving the business in your hands. I'm going to Hollywood to blank Gene Rayburn. You didn't hear it? You didn't hear it because I got a mouth full of sponges. Why, you didn't hear it. The godfather said, Vito, I'm leaving the business in your hands. I'm going to Hollywood to blank Gene Rayburn. Think about it. Are you ready over there? What the heck are you waiting for? Because
I hate to say it.
I was just gonna reach for my gat and my pocket is sewn up.
This is Match Game 74, production number 0202, take one.
Get ready to match the star. Bobby Vann. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly. Elaine Joyce. Richard Dawson and Betty White as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now here's the host of Match Game 74, Gene Rayburn.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Johnny Olson. Thank you for joining us here today. Are you all ready, gang?
Here, ready.
Splendid. I just want to say one thing before we carry on. This is the week that Bobby Vann is appearing at the Playboy Club in Lake Geneva, Wisconsin.
Right. Thank you very much. Okay. You got my dancing shoes on.
That's right.
Yes, wait, look at those Fred Astaire's. They're great.
He wears them all of his
let's
life.
Let's hear it, folks.
You had something to say? You had your hand raised, sir.
Is this the week that Bobby's going to play? Yesterday we had a thing for Annie on the board.
Oh, Annie Greensprings, yeah.
What was it last?
Well, I've got to say.
I never heard of that.
We didn't have time to explain it. It's a local product, a wine that apparently local people were familiar with, so we do owe the rest of the country an explanation.
Annie Greensprings is a wine, is it?
Yeah, all the local winos know about it. It's a local thing, so.
Annie Sterno, I've heard of.
Let's say hello to the current champ here, Debbie Marialdo. How are you?
Let's go.
As we ran out of time yesterday, Debbie had just won a game, and she had completed part of the super match in which she won $500. That means she's up to now $700, right? And she'll be having a go at $5,000. Are you ready for that?
Oh, I'm ready.
Okay, we'll do that right after we do this message for you. All right, here we go. Here's a lady. Let's stand right here so they can all see your pretty face, and we'll have a go at it. Now, you've won the $500. That means you're going to be playing for 10 times that amount, or $5,000. To collect, remember, you've got to match one celebrity on a head-to-head basis. It has to be an exact match, and it's time to choose one now.
I'm Bobby.
Bobby Van.
Right, okay.
You have been chosen. You get ready to write.
I appreciate your confidence.
Debbie, you face me. And I'll get the...
I like it better when she faces me, if you don't mind.
Here it is. Fill in, write your answer to this, if you please. Marriage blank. Marriage blank.
Marriage blank. Okay.
Marriage blank.
Okay.
All right, Bobby is finished. Now we need a response from you, Debbie. How do you fill in that blank? Marriage...
Contract.
Contract. If the phone rings, I'll answer it, but I don't know about that. Is that a good one?
That's a good one.
That's a good one. She says that's a good one, and don't call her.
They all go around and boo, right? But I believe that license and contract are the same thing.
Marriage license and marriage contract? No.
No, it isn't.
The rule says, sorry, has to be an exact match. We say that at the beginning of every time.
License and contract.
But you're both on the same wavelength there, and it may happen next time if you win another game. Who knows? But right now, Debbie, you're going to play another game, meet another challenger. Here comes Jolene Lehman.